Yeah, I'll take a left over here.
Some juniors trying to bypass the natural order of high school and infiltrate the
sometimes they even actually it seems unprotected when they act, and are willing to go to extreme lengths to protect them. The beautiful land of the butterfly, so rich with activity among its inhabitants. We are down here on the ground, inside of the park, where a lot of the action happens. Here you can see a timid underclassman being smuggled off campus by a dog. See? It's just so interesting, the things you can see in the wild. If a student is late for school, which seniors often are, it can be near impossible to find a parking spot. Here, we can see a senior struggling to find a parking spot in this wild jungle. Here's some of the natural noises this exquisite habitat has to offer.
Behind me is the vertical sign for Mr. Wayne. The visitor parking lot is one of the most famous attractions of Wayne High School.
Here are a few words from some of our students.
The Wayne High School parking lot is a very dangerous place.
Thank you.
Pastor sent out an all-school email.
Oh, what did he say?
I have literally no idea how to do that.
Just reply it all.
Did you even read the email?
No. Oh my gosh, Quincy, why did you send the entire school the whole B-movie script? I was just feeling whimsical. What does whimsical mean?
Hey, don't worry, I can find that out. Someone just sent the entire encyclopedia. Alright, well...
Oh my gosh, Quincy! You did not need to bust out Mr. Gaston for the entire school like that! What are you sending?
I am so sorry.
It's alright. Wow.
Charlie, how are you feeling today?
You know, I'm feeling pretty good. How are you?
I'm good.
It took a really long time to write out the B-movie. I should have probably just copied and pasted it, but, you know.
Well, I don't think that is really necessary this time. We have a boy band that was supposed to be showing up.
Oh. Is that No Direction? Oh,
that is.
No, wait! Listen!
That is No Direction.
Lieutenant Lee Brown! Next song is Marry You by Bruno Mars. And feel free to sing along with Yellow.
No. was the lead singer.
No, surely!
Yes, Riley!
I'm the lead singer!
Guys, these are amazing points that you guys are making, right? But they will be better off with Fresh Long and Wayland updates.
Hey, speaking of which, I hear there are a lot of updates to be made. Let's take a look.
We are excited to bring the latest updates from Boston, Massachusetts.
Wayland.
For legal reasons, we have to declare that our information is sourced directly from the Wayland Community Forum.
Our first news story tonight is...
Oh, my socks are wet.
Powder Puff's been canceled.
I've just been informed that Powder Puff has been canceled for the 2023 school year.
We are deeply saddened to see this lasting tradition finally come to an end.
For the fourth year in a row, there have been boys on our field hockey team. Emily, how long do you think this newfound tradition will last?
There are boys on our field hockey team?
An interesting topic for sure. A culture shock was brought into our community in 2019 when three boys joined the field hockey team, a predominantly girls team for decades.
That's old news. Isn't there something new we can discuss?
Well, the other day I took a left on these in and I got some stares and honks. Doesn't make sense to me.
Yo, you're a brave soul, boy. Imagine an accomplishment like the Ice Age.
You legally cannot turn left on Gleason. Where are you even going?
Keyword being legally.
Definitely not the town center. That place has more vacancy than this water bottle. And it's empty.
You see it in the comments of every post. Somebody's looking for a plumber, but instead you get folks referring to some left turn on Gleason. I say you just go for it.
Are you actually saying you turn left on Gleason?
Yes.
A road's meant to be driven on, unless you're a road cyclist.
Powder Puff's back on.
I've just been informed that Powder Puff is back on for the class of 2023, but will not continue for the class of 2024.
Power Puff Girls!
I love Power Puff Girls! Who's your favorite character?
Jesus Christ, will you two please knock it off?
Yo, wow.
For once, you might be right about something. For the first time in over a year, water fountains at Wayland High School have come out of hibernation.
It's about time the water fountains went back on. You know, I was tired from going all the way to the history wing, to the weight room, and back just for a bottle of water.
Hey, gotta do what you gotta do for some peace and quiet. That's just where I go poop.
Our girls don't do that. In other news, Wayland Town Meeting, does it still exist? All I ever hear people argue about is the Olympic Field.
Isn't that the place where the missiles were?
Yo, we had missiles? That's crazy.
No, that was Oxbow. Yes, we had a 19 missile site during the Cold War. Now, can you two please stop?
I haven't seen someone get this worked up in St. Patrick's Day.
You guys ready for grad party season? Yeah, I know you're gonna throw a huge party.
Yes!
And get my college admissions rescinded? My parents will kill me if they don't go to an Ivy. I can't ruin my family's six-generation streak at Cornell.
Calm down, dork.
Dollar for the college? Gap year is my name written all over it since third quarter sophomore year. Gosh, I'm
in wellness class.
Dude, that was COVID year. How do you fail online jumping jacks?
I guess I couldn't pop it and lock it like Mr. Barry in those Zoom dance classes.
Powder Puff's canceled.
I've just been informed that Powder Puff is canceled again for the class of 2023. Start trying to find a new tradition, juniors, because you are out of luck. Sorry, seniors. To finish things off, the citizens of Wayland are in desperate need of the following. Dog walking, babysitting, plowing services, electricians, plumbers, carpenters, mechanics, and tutors.
Did you say plowing services? You're telling me people needed plowing services for the inch of snow we got this year?
Sounds like a payday to me. All you need is a shovel.
That's all the time we have. Join us next month on Wayland Update.
Oh my god. This might be my best B-reel yet. You guys all look amazing, by the way. Oh my god. Katie, a part of the acapella, I think they're here right now. I'm gonna go see if I can get them on stage for the next year.
Going out tonight changes into something red. Her mother doesn't like that kind of dress. Everything she ever had, she's showing off. Driving too fast, moon is breaking through air. She's heading for something that she won't forget. Having no regrets is all that she really wants. Chasing into night, doubts are running round her head. He's waiting, hides behind a cigarette. Heart is beating loud and she doesn't want it to stop. Moving too fast, moon is lighting up her skin. He's falling, doesn't even know it yet. Having no regrets is all that she really wants. Getting older, baby, and I've been thinking about it lately. Does it ever drive you crazy? Just how fast the night changes. Everything that you ever dreamed of disappearing when you wake up. But there's nothing to be afraid of, even when the night Going out tonight changes into something red. Her mother doesn't like the kind, it just reminds her of the missing piece of innocence she lost. We're only getting older, baby, and I've been thinking about it lately. Does it ever drive you crazy? Just how fast the night changes. Everything that you ever dreamed of disappearing when you wake up. But there's nothing to be afraid of. When the night changes, it will never change, baby. It will never change, baby. It will never change me and you.
Arranged by Katie Shelton and Grant Lee, and solo by Zachary Greenberg. The next song that we're going to do is Gimme Gimme Gimme, originally by ABBA, arranged by Roger Rumby and solo by Emily Kempis.
Thank you. car. B, respectfully tell them it's not allowed. C, report them to the police. Or D, ignore them completely. Yes, Billy?
D, ignore them completely.
No.
No way. I say A, smuggle them into my car, but only if they pay for my food. You know, I used to be able to get a large sandwich for $7 and drink for $1.50. Now I can't even get a small sandwich for $7. Inflation is ruining this country. At least Arizona's are still 99 cents.
The answer is a D or A. It's B. Respectfully tell them it's not allowed.
I'll just say that.
How? What do you mean how?
How is the answer B? I mean C, reporting to the police isn't.
Okay. Question 3. In underclass, a freshman needs help with an English essay and asks for one of your old essays. Do you A, give them the essay? B, give them a different essay and tell them to copy it completely. C, tell them to complete the assignment on their own. Or D, ignore them completely. Yeah, Billy.
D, ignore them completely.
Wrong again.
This actually happened to me earlier this year.
Yes, yeah,
a junior asked to borrow one of my papers.
No way.
I know, they can be so desperate sometimes.
No, right?
What did you guys do?
I gave them one of my papers, like, just because.
Really? That wasn't your best decision.
Why? What did you do?
I just gave some sophomore the wrong essay.
Man, that's awesome.
Man, that's awesome.
Thank you for your news tonight. I'm Isabel Helpful, here with Andrew Huber. We come to you with breaking news.
The third time this week, the peaceful town of Wilton has been hit with a series of suspicious thefts. News Center 5's Julia Caulfield breaks it down.
The tiny town of Wayland, a place not known for its crime.
I moved here because it's safe, but after what happened today, I'm prepared to move.
For the third time this week, a yellow traffic van has been stolen here in Wayland. Police say they have no interest in pursuing these petty criminals.
It's a $30 sign that would cost our department thousands of dollars to catch these thieves. Financially, it doesn't make any sense.
I really wish we had the fine, but why was that so bad?
Studies have shown that neighborhoods are safer with the yellow traffic guys. A study of Gleason Lane showed that traffic volume decreased after July of 2022 from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. The family says their sign was put up in June. Wayland police are asking people to refrain from making left turns.
These traffic men are about $30 each. The family has declined a request for comment, but through their attorney, we are told that they desperately want it back. For Channel 5 News, this is Julia Caulfield.
the third time.
Why does it matter? Our kids are all grown up.
It's not just for us, it's the whole neighborhood. Something has to be done. We should call the police.
Fine, I'll call. Yes? Hello, I'd like to report a theft? Kidnapping? I'm not sure. About 3'2", bald guy, reflected, no clothes. Really look missing. That's what I thought. Hey, kid.
It's gotta be the commons.
Yep, he's him.
I knew they were gonna take the commons.
And it makes perfect sense. We can eat and we can be as loud as we want.
And last time I checked, the commons is the only place with the sound system.
I'll admit, that's a wise pick for sure.
Yeah, Mike, it's a pretty good pick. Now, with our second round pick, we're gonna go with... Oh, I'm excited about this one. The conference rooms.
We think that the conference rooms and the media center will complement each other quite nicely.
You're certainly creating a strong starting five, but I think you may have overlooked it. The SLCs have really been putting effort and they're playing the students strong.
Yep, with new tables and chairs.
A sleeper pick for sure. Quite literally, the top three laughing pick.
I'll admit, you know, I've napped there a bunch of times.
Yeah, it's a pretty good pick. Now, I'm pretty excited with our third round pick. We're taking the Academic Center. It's got teachers, tutors, and tons of resources for help. It's a triple threat that I can run my offense through.
Plus, this next one is the thing that High Fleur does that she doesn't know I know about.
No, I really respect that pick, dude. Having the Academic Center and the Media Center, that's huge for the team.
That duo's
going to
be really tough to defend this season.
Yep. However, for our third pick, we're taking the department offices.
Now, we know they're not exactly meant for students to be working, but you get to listen to all the faculty members.
The history department's my go-to for sure.
I don't know. I think science has gotten me this one.
There's a science office? Where?
Okay, well, just moving on. I'm pretty excited for our fourth round pick. This player is heavily overlooked, but I believe he can be just as good as the commons. Maybe even the media center.
Just choose.
I hate this kid.
But just listen, the lecture hall.
Freshman.
Well, we think that the lecture hall and the conference rooms are going to work perfectly together.
Questionable fourth round pick there, dude.
It's my team and not yours.
Anyway, for our fourth pick, we put a lot of thought into this. We're taking the hallway benches in the north building.
Flag?
Flag?
Who studies there, please? Tell me who studies there. Tell me who studies
there. Bring out the rep
group.
Moving to a new school can always be hard. Let's take a peek at the life of a new
Shakespeare's Hamlet.
In one word, how would you describe your department?
Trenchant. When you say awesome, we're awesome.
Awesome. Can I ask why you're whispering?
What are you talking about? This is how I speak. Okay. I just got to a really good place here.
Thank you.
Okay,
guys. Next up, Matthew. Wonderful. Math is our little evil's favorite subject. Isn't that right, Alex?
Yeah, you're always using that math scale and measuring thingy.
Yeah, but I don't know anything else to say.
How many grams in an ounce?
28 or 4.
I'm Miss Sneesland.
What is your favorite thing about math?
You know, really, what I like about math is getting to use my calculator and you get to do really fun things like this.
In one word, how would you describe your department?
Super cool.
Miss Sneesland, that's actually two words.
Doesn't that count as one word? Just cool, that doesn't describe it. I mean, two words, super cool.
Okay.
Wait, pocket protector.
Lastly, do you know why computer science isn't a science class?
Why don't we go to the history room next?
Wait, is this the science one?
All right, I forgot that was accurate. Wait, we're in science classrooms.
I think I see a science teacher in here.
Hi, what's your name?
Ichthyology? Ichthyology is the study of fish.
We have a lot of fun studying fish.
In one word, how would you describe your department?
My department. My department is a group of idiosyncratic and very intelligent people who really want students to learn. But you should really join the Ichthyology Club. You have a great group of kids. You spend a lot of time.
Rumor has it that the science classes are some of the toughest classes here at Wuhai. What's your take on that?
Well, let's see. AP Bio, now that's breeze. AP Chem, oh, you can definitely do that easily. AP Physics, that takes nothing. I don't know. But you should really join the ichthyology club. Some peppers. As I said, we study fish, all kinds, freshwater, salt.
All right, now we get in this room. My opinion, one of the best places in the world, that's not the best. You have a great beautiful school.
Hey, what's going on out there?
Right.
Which he decided he would.
There's a number of them.
Let's start with the one that you discussed most.
Okay. Well.
y'all have lockers at Loyola High School?
Nah, definitely not.
All right, here's your locker. Come on, 10.
Script.